Alright, hi everyone. I am back with another review today. You know, I just thought I would do another review. It's Friday, and I forgot about this guy, and I've been wanting to review him for a while. I just forgot him, so I looked on my shelf today and saw that he needed to be reviewed. So, today we are taking a look at the Star Wars Black Series, number 2, Darth Vader. This guy has been on my list for a while now. I'm very selective with Black Series 6-inch figures, so I only have three. I only have, of course, Darth Vader, I have Han Solo, and Slave Leia. I really want, Emperor Palpatine and the Bausch Leia, but unfortunately I'm out of work right now, so I can't really afford anything, so, but those are my two wants really bad. So, before we take a look at Vader, we'll take a look at, the box. It's in the newer style box, with the blue and in the circle at the top. Right there we have a nice image of Vader. I got this guy at a comic shop for $20, which is retail price pretty much. Star Wars the Black Series logo. Number 2 Darth Vader. Another Star Wars logo. After Darth Vader and Luke Skywalker join forces to defeat the Emperor, Vader asks Luke to help him remove the mask that covers his face. I just, for once, want, let me look on you with my own eyes and live an image. I always wish those were colored. I think they would be very better if they were colored. And then there's the Disney logo, Hasbro logo, and more information down there. So there's the packaging. We'll start off with Darth's articulation. He has a ball jointed head, which I'm actually very surprised. You would think he would just have a swivel head, but no, he has a ball jointed head. He has ball and shoulders, ball and elbows, swivel wrist, a jointed torso, ball and hips, ball and knees, and ball hinge ankles. So this guy is, which I'm really shocked about, is packed with articulation. So if you're an articulation lover, you will like this figure. I like articulation and all, but I'm more for the sculpts and stuff. But let's just take a quick look at his body. You can see the armor right here is really good. This figure is a mixed bag for me, honestly, and I'll get to that in a minute why. I really do like his controls there. They're nicely painted. Then his belt is right there, and it's just black on the other side. But, it has some more controls. Green buttons, gray buttons. And then, of course, his leg area is just pretty much all black. And, this is back. The chain right here is actually real, if I can get it, but it's kind of stuck right now, but the chain right there is actually real. Now, one of the things I am not too fond about is, now I heard this in a lot of other people's reviews and of this, especially Victoria's Cantina, and I have to agree with her. The cape is just way too long. It's just everywhere. I understand that he had probably a cape like this in the movie, but for the figure-wise, they should have just cut, maybe made it a little shorter. I mean, I like that it can drag and stuff, but it's just everywhere, and even his undercape, his tunic right here is too long. Maybe if it was about maybe there, it would have been better. So yeah, it's just way too long. And they do have these little things that hold down his cape. So his hands are pretty cool. Of course, he has that I am your father look pose right there. His face, his helmet right here. It looks to me, you can't really see it on camera, but his mask looks more like the A New Hope version, because his eyes are red like the New Hope version. So I really think this guy should have been put in a New Hope box instead of Return of the Jedi, because they could have released another one for Return of the Jedi, but I know why they put this for Return of the Jedi, because his helmet is removable. Again, they could have released another one with a removable helmet and just left this one as is with no helmet, but we'll go ahead and take that off. But before I do that, I do want to just take the mask off, and the mask is two parts. And this is like the vintage collection Vader, where his mask was two parts, but that figure, the helmet came off really easily. This one doesn't fall out or anything, so it's pretty cool. I just wish this was more of a New Hope line. And I think his face is excellent. I think they did a great job. Unfortunately, there's a little scuff on his nose, but on his face, I think it really looks like him when he did in Return of the Jedi. I do like the scarring right here. I wish maybe there was a little bit more red or something. But I think the face is really good, and you can see part of his mask right there. And let me see. As I said, there is the chain right here. And it's actually real. So this is a great face sculpt, especially for 6-inch mind. What I'm going to do is just go ahead and put his helmet back on. His other accessory is, hold on, let me just get, he's not standing for some reason. There he goes. Is a lightsaber, and it's a two-piece lightsaber. You can take the blade off, which I'm always, at least with the 3-inch figures, come on, I'm always worried that these are going to break, because they have broken on me before. But there is nicely done. The hilt is nice. And what you can do is you can obviously place it in his hand right here. And he looks pretty cool. I wish there was a place, and I wish there was a hook on the lightsaber where you could hang it, like on his belt or something, but unfortunately there isn't. So on all, I like this guy. Let me just see if he'll stand. My only complaint is really the helmet. It looks more like New Hope. And then the long cape. I mean, I usually like long capes, but it might have worked better if it was plastic, maybe. But it's just everywhere, as you can see. Like, and this cape does take a lot of room on the shelf. Really fast, I do just want to compare him to, as for height, Han Solo. I think Vader is a good size. I don't have a Luke to compare him to, but I think Vader is a good size and a good scale for other 6-inch figures. As you can see, here's Han and Vader. As I said, good scale. But those are really my only two complaints, is the cape and the mask. My favorite part has to be the face sculpt. I think they did an excellent job on the face sculpt and the head, and I just would have liked to see maybe a New Hope Vader released first, and they could have done this Vader maybe later in the series. Because, you know, Vader is one of the most popular Star Wars characters, and he's my fifth favorite Star Wars character, Anakin Vader. So it would have been, and I'm sure there's probably plans for other Anakin and stuff. So today's review was on the Star Wars The Black Series, Darth Vader, the 6-inch figure. Tomorrow I will be trying to do two reviews, and on Sunday I will be trying to do two reviews if I can. So stay tuned for that. Thank you for watching. Until next time, bye-bye.